Hey everyone, this is John from Show Me Pickers, and I wanted to make a real quick video talking about what you need to do if you get that dreaded suspension letter from eBay. And we're going to talk about four things that you need to do right after the intro. Try to catch me howling at the moon. Okay guys, something that I've been seeing a lot of on these eBay forums is that people are getting suspended, and while the ones that are getting permanently suspended, eBay is being mum on why they're getting suspended. I don't know why they won't tell these people what they did wrong, but eBay is just like, we can't tell you what you did. You're suspended and we can't tell you. So what do? When you get in that situation, how can you rectify the situation? Well, let's first say that not all suspensions are permanent. Some suspensions, you can get like a 1, a 3, a 7, a 30-day suspension. You can be suspended indefinitely. You can be suspended permanently from eBay. But the first thing that you do when you get that dreaded letter is, one, you got to stay calm. You stay calm. You don't want to get overly excited. You don't want to jump right on the phone and just call eBay and be like, what's going on? What's going on? You want to stay calm, and two, you don't want to click any links. It could be a phishing email. You might not even be suspended from eBay. It could be a spoof email. They're trying to get you to click their links so that you can go to a malicious website so that they can get your eBay information so that they can steal your account and list all kinds of stuff on there so that they can get money. That's just what they do. Three is call eBay. Once you have sat down, you've calmed yourself, you've been composed, you realize that the world has not ended, you sit down and you call eBay. When you call eBay, you're going to hopefully get a rep that understands the suspension process, and you're going to be able to ask them questions like, what did I do wrong? Sometimes they'll tell you, sometimes there'll be a reason, and sometimes they won't tell you anything. But what you do is you definitely want to call eBay. You want to try to find a rep that is compassionate and that will help you through this process. We have never been suspended permanently on eBay, obviously, because we still sell there. But I did receive a 7-day suspension one time for doing something wrong. I threatened a buyer because they bought something from me, left me negative feedback. They were a seller. I went and bought something from them stupidly and told them in the message that if they I'm gonna hold them to the same standard that they held me to, and they contacted eBay and I was suspended for 7 days. Yes, that was probably 15 years ago, maybe 10 years ago, but I was suspended from eBay for 10 days. So if you get a rep and if they can help you walk you through what you did wrong and maybe tell you what you need to do. Like if your returns are too high, they can maybe tell you what you need to do to get those returns up. Maybe after 30 days, some of those will fall off and you'll get your account back. Something else that you need to look into is your other metrics, such as cancellations. Here's a big one. You do not want to cancel orders to eBay buyers. You want to fulfill almost every order that you can get in, even if it means going on eBay and buying it from someone else, or even going over to Amazon. If it's a newer item and you can buy it from Amazon and ship it to them, you're better off to do that than to cancel. But here's the secret. I'm going to tell you guys a secret. If you do end up having to cancel an item, this is what I do personally. Say if I am selling a hat. I've got a little sailor hat here and I want to sell it. But say if I listed it and say if it's the wrong size hat. Say if this one here is it's a large. But I had it listed as a small. Instead of just going in and canceling that item, I will message the buyer and I will say, hey, there was an error in the listing. It was a small and not a large. Do you still want it? If not, would you like me to cancel? And if they say, no, I needed a large, I would like you to cancel, then you can cancel that order, and it is because the buyer asked you to cancel it. They want you to cancel it. Also, say if you sold this hat and you can't find it, it's gone. The hat is gone. You message the buyer and you're like, hey, I can't find this item, but what I would love to do is send you a similar item, or I could get you this item from one of my suppliers, which goes back to, sorry, I got the itchy nose, which goes back to being able to order it from another eBay seller or another website and tell them that it might take a little bit longer to get to you, but I wanted to know if you would like me to do that, or would you like me to cancel the item? And if they say cancel the item, then you can cancel because the buyer requested it. You're still going to fulfill their expectations, but being the fact that if they decide they don't want it, then that's not on you anymore. That's now on them, and you can cancel it. So that's important. You want to keep those metrics high because that's going to safeguard your account. But apparently, there's just some random reason out there that eBay is not telling people what they did. So one of the things that I can tell you is also don't log in on your eBay account on strange computers. Don't go to the library unless you have to. If that's where you run your eBay business from, bad idea. You're better off to get a phone and to run your business off your phone if you can. They have printers that will print from your phone. You can use your phone to print even your shipping labels. But don't log into strange computers, because if someone logs into that computer and they have an account on that IP and they've logged into an eBay account that has been, cut, then you could get in trouble. Like, they could try to link your two accounts together through the same IP, and then you could lose your account. So I'm very strange about that. I don't give my Wi-Fi passwords out to anyone who sells on eBay, because I tell them that my internet is for business only, and I can't run the risk of losing my eBay account because they connect the two accounts together and they did something stupid, because it just ain't worth it. I don't want to go back to work full time for anyone else. I want to work for myself. So that's a couple of ways that you can keep from getting your account suspended. Definitely call eBay. Hopefully they can help you. If they're of no help, you can contact eBay for Business through Facebook. They actually have a Facebook page. This is number 4. And a lot of times they can help work you through the process, or they'll just tell you that you're indefinitely suspended. And I can't give you an answer as to why. They won't tell people why they're suspended. All I can do is tell you that if you're suspended and they won't tell you why, I don't know, you don't know, they might not even know you're just suspended. So there are ways to get around that, but I'm not going to tell you guys what they are because I don't want to make eBay mad at me, but I know people who do get around those suspensions. And so the thing to remember, though, is to be polite with these people. Be polite, be courteous, be humble, and that's very important. And a couple of other things to keep you from getting suspended is, one, is to know your Vero items. Know what items are on Vero. Don't use the word Velcro. Don't use the word onesie. Don't use certain words that are keywords that will get you kicked off because they're common descriptors for items that we use every day, but in reality, they are trademarked items. Stay away from Planet Hollywood stuff. There's a whole list of them. If you go to Google and you type in eBay Vero list, it will come up. And another thing is, like I said, to keep an eye on your returns and just don't refund your buyer for being out of stock. Find another way around it. Use another method that I told you earlier in the video. So I hope this video was helpful. If it was, go down below and hit that subscribe button, maybe even hit the like button. I appreciate you guys for watching. If you know something that you would like to add to the list, if you think there was something that should have been in the video, let me know down below, and hopefully in the future, I will be able to incorporate that into maybe an updated video. Because hey, this is what I've done in the past to help people, and this is the advice that I have given on eBay forums. I spend a lot of time on eBay Thrifters. I really like that group. You'll see me there under Show Me Pickers, and I try to give a lot of advice because I'm not just here to make money on YouTube. I really am passionate about reselling, and I'm passionate about helping you guys. So there you go. You have a good day. God bless you guys. Keep on digging, keep on picking, and remember, the family that picks together sticks together. God bless you guys.